Sardinia has been of special interest to geneticists for decades, the reason being that it is the only place in Europe that has retained a genetic profile similar to the Neolithic first farmers originally from Anatolia. The paper, Genetic History from the Middle Neolithic to Present on the Mediterranean Island of Sardinia in Nature Communications, studies the genetic history of the island. In this paper, they generated genome-wide ancient DNA data for 70 individuals from 21 Sardinian archaeological sites spanning the Middle Neolithic through the medieval period. Europe was first inhabited by Paleolithic and late Mesolithic hunter-gatherer groups. Then, starting about 7000 BC, farming peoples arrived from the Middle East as part of a Neolithic transition, spreading through Anatolia and the Balkans while progressively admixing with local hunter-gatherers. Major moment from the Eurasian steppe, the Indo-European expansion, beginning about 3000 BC, resulted in further admixture throughout Europe. These events are typically modeled in terms of three ancestry components: Western hunter-gatherers, early European farmers, and steppe pastoralists. Within this broad framework, the island of Sardinia is thought to have received a high level of early European farmers' ancestry early on, and then retained mostly isolated from the subsequent admixture occurring on mainland Europe. The oldest known human remains on Sardinia date to 20,000 years ago. Archaeological evidence suggests Sardinia was not densely populated in the Mesolithic and experienced a population expansion coinciding with the Neolithic transition in the 6th millennium BC. Around this time, early Neolithic pottery assemblages were spreading throughout the western Mediterranean, including Sardinia, with radiocarbon dated indicating a rapid westward maritime expansion around 5,500 years BC. In the later Neolithic, obsidian originating from Sardinia is found throughout many western Mediterranean archaeological sites, indicating that the island was integrated into a maritime trade network. And in the Middle Bronze Age, about 1600 BC, the Nuragic culture emerged, named for the thousands of distinctive stone towers known as Nuragi. During the late Neolithic period, the archaeological and historical records show the direct influence of several major Mediterranean groups, in particular the presence of Mycenaean, Levantine and Cypriot traders. The Nuragic settlements declined throughout much of the island, as in the late 9th and early 800 BC, Phoenicians originating from present-day Lebanon and northern Palestine established settlements concentrated along the southern shores of Sardinia. In the second half of the 6th century BC, the island was occupied by Carthaginians, also known as Punics, expanding from the city of Carthage on the North African coast of present-day Tunisia, which was founded in the late 9th century BC by Phoenicians. Sardinia was occupied by Roman forces in 237 BC and turned into a Roman province a decade later. Throughout the Roman imperial period, the island remained closely aligned with both Italy and central North Africa. After the fall of the Roman Empire, Sardinia became increasingly autonomous, but interactions with the Byzantine Empire and the maritime republics of Genoa and Pisa and the Catalan and Aragonese kingdoms, as well as the Duchy of Savoy and Piemont, continued to influence the island. In this paper, they investigated three aspects of Sardinian population history. First, the ancestry of individuals from the Sardinian Neolithic. Who were they? Second, the genetic structure through the Sardinian Chalcolithic to the Sardinian Bronze Age. In particular, were there genetic turnover events through the different culture transitions observed in the archaeological record? And third, the post-Bronze Age contact with major Mediterranean civilizations and more recent Italian populations, have they resulted in a detectable gene flow. They found low differentiation between middle-late Neolithic Sardinian individuals and Neolithic Western mainland European populations, in particular groups from Spain and southern France. When projecting ancient individuals onto the top of two principal components defined by modern variations, the Neolithic ancient Sardinian individuals sit between early Neolithic Iberian and later Copper Age Iberian populations, roughly on an axis that differentiates Western hunter-gatherer and early European farmer populations. This result is also evident in terms of the genetic differentiation, with little difference between middle-late Neolithic and Neolithic Western mainland European populations. Ancient Sardinian individuals are shifted towards the Western hunter-gatherer individuals on the top of the two-piece principal component relative to the early Neolithic Anatolians. In a two-way admixture model between Western hunter-gatherers and Neolithic Anatolian populations similar to other Western European populations of the early Neolithic, they estimate ancient Sardinian individuals to harbor hunter-gatherer ancestry close to one-fifth, that is higher than early Neolithic mainland populations, including Iberia, where we observe about one-tenth, but lower than Copper Age Iberians of about one-fourth. They then find a genetic continuity from the Sardinian Middle Neolithic into the Bronze Age and Nuragic times, in stark contrast to ancient individuals from the mainland, such as Central Europe, where we see a large influx from the steppe. Then, from the Nuragic period to present-day Sardinia, there is admixture of a modest steppe-like ancestry component, but generally less than continental present-day European populations, and the appreciable Eastern Mediterranean ancestry component, also inferred at a high fraction in other present-day Mediterranean populations such as Sicily and Greece. Following the Nuragic period, they found evidence of gene flow with both Northern and Eastern Mediterranean sources. Furthermore, they observed Eastern Mediterranean ancestry appearing first in the two Phoenician Punic sites. The Northern Mediterranean ancestry became prevalent later. That is all for today. Thank you for listening. Till next time, I wish you all the best.